Hello, I am Julien Leworth from Visual Production, and in this video, I will show you how you can merge two different custom feature files from the software Cuety from Visual Production. And so the first question is why I should want to merge those two custom feature files for Cuety. So the answer is really simple, is that it's just that Cuety can only manage one of those custom feature files. So if you already have one, you're already using one in your Cuety software, and you create or ask for a new one, you will have a second custom feature files. And as I just said, Cuety can only manage one custom feature file. So now you get two, and then you need to merge those two files to get only one and get all your features, the old one and the new one, into this only one custom feature file. So here is my situation. Here I get my Cuety open, and if I go in my patch, you will see that in the library I got one custom manufacturer here. It's ProLite. That's the one between brackets, mean that the custom one. Okay, and now I got new models, and I want to add my new models to the existing custom feature files. So my new models are in the builder here. So here you see I get different manufacturer, it's a big list, and I want to merge those manufacturers and those models into my existing custom feature files, custom file. So what I first do is the Cuety export. That's just the final step, in fact, because before I created all my features. And to do that, you need this software that is free, and you can find it here. You go on the website of Visual Production, you go on download section, and you can find the macOS version, the Windows version, and the Linux. So I'm using Windows, and I say it now, it will be in French. My Windows is in French because I'm French. That's why I got a terrible accent in speaking English. Anyway, so you get your VBuilder software, you then read the manual. Where can I find the manual? That's a good question. Here, and you go in the Visual Production website, you go on download section, and then you go down, or you can click on manuals directly, or you go down, and here, oh, you get manuals, and then you can find the VBuilder manual in English, in Dutch, and you can find it in English and Dutch. Yeah, whoa. So once you read the manual, if you still have some blank parts, you can go on YouTube and you can read the tutorial video about the VBuilder. And so after that, I guess you will be able to create your custom features, and because it's easy, in fact. And once you've done that, you just click on Cuety export, and then you created your Cuety custom feature files. So now I want to see my custom feature file, the real file, where is it? So I will close this, and I go in the Explorer here, and I go in User, Documents, and then in Visual Productions, and I go in VBuilder, and in VBuilder I will have User.personality file. So here you see that it will open with Notepad. So I don't know how it will be for you. So if it's not linked to Notepad, you can make a right click and click on Open With and select Notepad, like this. Let's hit full screen. And here you can see what is inside your file, that you can see that it's full text. And that's why it will be easy for us to merge the files, because you can read everything. It's all black and white here, it's not really easy to show you something and to understand when you don't know what you're looking at. So I will use a different software. The software I will use is called Notepad++, and if you want to use it, you just need to go on the internet, and here you go on Google, you type Notepad++, you go on download, and then you can download it. And you will see that it's much more easy to read, so I just make right click, edit with Notepad, and here is my file. In this file you will start, let's start like this. So the way the file is done, it's just that it's like folders. That means you will have a personality folder. Inside this folder, you have manufacturers. Inside these manufacturers folders, you will have models. And inside each model folder, you will have modes. So here you can see the small plus here. And if I click on it, it will open the personality folder. And then you can see, as I said, the manufacturers. And if I click, for example, on this plus, I will open the tip-top manufacturer folder. And in this manufacturer folder, I can see models here. So this model don't have plus. That means that's only one mode. But this one get a plus, I can open, and you can see that I have two different modes. So now I just need to copy-paste the folder I need from my new file to the old file. So if you want to copy just a model, you will copy the folder, the model folder. So it will be from the model line where you have the model name. Here you can see TPB52. And this folder will finish at slash model. So if I want to copy this, I will just select from here to here and then make a copy paste. If I want to copy paste the wall manufacturer, I will do the same, but from the manufacturer name here, tip top, until the slash manufacturer. So let's open the custom feature file that I'm using with Cuety. Here I go in Explorer, I go in Visual Production, and this time I will open the programmer folder. So the programmer is, it's like the Qt folder. That's here, you see the user.personality file here. It's the file that is Qt reading when it's opening. So I need to edit this one. So I will edit with Notepad. And if I close all the folders, you can see that in my personality folder, I get only one manufacturer, that is ProLite, and it fits what I showed you at the beginning of the video in my Qt library. So I want to add the tip-top manufacturer. So I will select from manufacturer tip-top till the slash manufacturer here. Copy, and then paste. So now where do I paste? You need to find the end of the last folder. So here we get only one manufacturer folder, so we need to find the end of this one. So we need to find for the slash manufacturer. We go down here, and here we get the slash manufacturer. So after this, we will paste our new manufacturer. So paste. So we've closed the folder ProLite here, and we open the new folder tip top here. Inside we get our models, and then we close the manufacturer model. And so I can save this, and I just want to take, for example, let's go in this one, and I want to take this model, for example. I just want to add this model. So I will select the model name until the slash model. And I do the same, copy, I go into the other file, and I will add it to the tip top, because you don't have to put your models in the same manufacturer. You can put your models everywhere you want. So my feature, that is RGB 4-in-1, is from Epsilon Light folder, and I will put it in the tip top because I want to do it, and I can, so I do it. So just here, I look like previously, I was looking for the end of the manufacturer folder. Here I look for the end of the model folder. So it's here, you see. So I can paste here, I paste, and I get a new model. So I save, and now I just need to open Cuety and check. Cuety. Patch, personality, and then at the top we have ProLite, like in our previous custom feature file, and now we got tip top because I had it here. And in tip top you can see I got my fixtures, and I found also the fixture I copy paste from the Epsilon Light manufacturer into the tip top. So it's done, and it worked, because now I can see everything in Cuety library. So you see, it's quite easy. So here is my quick advice. It's just you should use the Notepad++ because it's much more easy to do it when you get colors than just using the Notepad software where everything is black and white. And then when you start opening your file, just go in View and Fold All. That will close all your folders, and then you can slowly open exactly what you want to see. This way it's easier to read than you close. So that's it. I hope you like this video and it will be helpful for you. So thank you very much for watching, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.